So guys, in the previous video on my channel, I taught you how to build AI dumbbell shoulder press, right? And I also told you that we'll write the code in a way that is going to be reusable. So in today's tutorial, we are going to leverage that code and make some few changes to it so that we can build this project up. This project is AI squad counter. If you love artificial intelligence and computer vision, consider subscribing so that you don't miss any of my future projects. Alright guys, so thanks for tuning in. So if today is your first time visiting my channel, my name is Felix and I hope you consider subscribing so that you will no longer miss any of my future videos. So the project you are going to build today will be based on the previous video where I told you the code we are writing, we'll use it for a future video. So I'll go ahead and first run the previous project so that you guys will see what we've done, and that's the AI dumbbell shoulder press project. So we'll leverage that code and do some few modifications to it to build this project. So let me quickly run that project, and as shown, this is what we've been able to achieve in the previous video. So you can see how we are detecting the pose and also counting each time the hand is up and down. So we'll continue using the same code and we'll just do some few modifications to achieve today's result. So I'll go ahead and close this app. I have an empty AI squad counter file here. So I'll just copy the whole code here and paste it here so that we do our modification to it. So in order to understand this project, I highly recommend that you watch the previous project with them, because you are not going to write this whole code again. You are just coming to modify some certain steps so that we get whatever we want to work with. So the link will be in the description and it will also be somewhere at the top here so that you can just click and watch that video and learn how we came up with all this code before watching this one, for better understanding. So what we'll do is that now we can close this app, and instead of train.mov, the new video file we are working on will be squat. So we just type in squat here, squat.mov, and that's all. So we can go ahead and run this. I don't think that's the file. Let's run this one. And you can see we are detecting the pose on the hands, but today we are not focusing on the hands. All we want is to target the legs. So I think what we have to do now is to change the point and we'll get the pose on the leg. So we've written the code in such a way that when you give in any 6 points on the body, it will find the angle between each of the 3 points. So for clearer understanding, what we did the other day is that we gave it 0.12, 14 and 16 so that we find the angle at 0.14. We also gave it 0.11, 13 and 15 so that we find the angle at 0.13. So today we are working with 0.24, 26 and 28 so that we find the angle at 0.26. We do the same for the opposite leg, which we give 23, 25 and 27 so that we find the point at, sorry, so that we find the angle at 25, right? So right away we can just come in here at the down here and give it these new points instead of the previous points. So where is it? Okay, here is it. So instead of those points, we can just give it 0.24, 26. So we give it 24, 26, and 28. Then we come to the other side, we give it 23, 25, and 27. And 27. Okay, so these are the points we want to work with now. So I'll go ahead and also run this so that we'll see whether we can get the detection on the legs instead of the hand. And as you can see we are detecting the pulse on the leg on the 6 points we've given to it. So this is awesome. So now all we have to work on now is to change how things appear on the screen, such as the score, nothing is happening, and the rectangle simulating the leg movements, nothing is happening. So we have to go ahead and work on that too. To further explain this, what we've done is that we've given it 0.24, 26, 28 to find the angle at 26, and we've done the same for the opposite leg, which is 23, 25, 27 to find the angle at 25. So that's exactly what we've done here, giving it the angles. In case you don't understand, I still recommend you watch the previous video where we build all this from scratch. So now what we'll go ahead and do is to modify some sections of this code. And the first thing we'll do is that instead of retaining both two angles, we'll only retain one. But that means we are only going to work with one leg, right? And this leg range, I've worked on the range, and I'll just punch it in for you guys too. So instead of the range from negative 170 to 180, we'll change it to 42 to 143. Okay, and this still remains from 100 to 0. And I think we don't need this right angle here again, but we only want to work with one angle, so we only specify the left hand angle. In this case it's right, but I don't think we have to go ahead and change the variable names. Okay, so we are only retaining this left angle, and since it's a single variable, we don't have to put list there. Then when we come here, what we can also modify is that we are taking left and what right. We are taking two things, which was previously we are taking the left hand angle and the right hand angle. But what we'll do now is that we are only taking left, right? So we don't need this line of code here. And all we have to retain here is the left. And that's all. So when we come here also, we don't need anything right, because we are only working with the left leg in this case. So we can get rid of the right condition also here, but I work with only the left. Okay, then when we come here where we are converting the angles, we don't need the right, we just get rid of it. Then for the color changing, we also don't need it, we can get rid of it. The right angle, we can get rid of it, but for the left we need it, but we don't need this text here. Okay, all of these will get rid. Okay, so now with this we can continue to see whether we get some results. So I'll run this app now. Okay, so this is what we are getting so far. After clearing all those tabs, so you can see we don't have the other rectangle here. You can see it has updated now to 1. But I think we should bring this one down so that we start everything from here, but I don't cover the person raising the bar. So we'll do the same thing to this side also. We'll bring this bar down. So let's go ahead and just do that for now. So in order to bring that rectangle down, we'll just change the values here. That is its position on the screen. Then that's all. So instead of 400 here, we'll change it to 480. And also we can change the color to pure red. So for that, here will be 255. And here will be 0. Then if you change this color also, so here should be 0, then we take here to be 255 too. Okay, so that's fine. I think we have to go ahead and change this position on the Y1, that's the Y axis, to 280. Then we just do the same thing here, 480, and 280 as well. So here should also be 480. And let's run this up. Okay, so now you can see we've moved this rectangle down. And you can see it's working fine. Just as it's coming down, it's also going down, right? So that's a good result so far. And you can see this is very easy because in the previous lesson, we went ahead and used object-oriented way for writing the code. So this makes our code reusable, just as I told you in the previous video. So once again, I recommend you watch that video for clearer understanding of the code. Then you will understand why we are doing all these modifications and you understand how easy it is. Watching this straight up from the ground, you are not going to understand anything, so I recommend you watch that video. So in order to make the video repeat over and over, we can just come here, if not red, if not the red variable, which is a boolean, then we'll restart our frame. So we'll come here and copy this, our video file again, and once again we'll start reading it, after which we have to continue. So with this line of code, the video will play over and over and over again. It will never stop. Okay, so the next thing we have to do is to also move this one down here so that we can save space. We can at least see the guy as he's raising it up. We can see everything clearly. You have to move this and the score down somewhere on the screen here. So let's go ahead and do that. And okay, here is where we are printing that, so we can just move these values downwards so that we work with it. So we'll put 380 here to move it down, and also we'll put 480 here so that it goes to the down. Okay, that's 480. And the color will make it white, so all 255. Okay, I think that's fine now. Then we have to move the score itself downwards. So for now, it will start from 3 and then we'll put it at 450. Okay, so let's give it a try now. Okay, so you can see where we've put in it now, which looks a little bit cleaner than before. Okay, this up is one, so the pose is not really working well on this leg. That's two, so I think this is working good now. That's three. This red, I think we should change it. The rectangle is red and the bar filling it is also red, so we can just go ahead and change it. So let's make the original rectangle yellow. For that we have to put 255 here and run it again. So I have previous videos about how rectangles work, so if you don't get whatever we are doing, you can check on the channel rectangles, shapes and all those. I have videos on them so that you check it out. So you can see we have yellow bar here, and as it's up and down, it's just filling it. It's one now and down, it's up, then it becomes two. So guys, I think this is an awesome result. As you can see, everything is working perfectly in my opinion, though we can modify this or there are certain things we can tweak about this, but I think it's good. So as usual, if you enjoy it, give me a thumb up. I'll put the link of the code, which is my GitHub repository in this case. I'll put it in the description so that you can have access to it. So thanks for tuning in, guys.